9 forecast.
Oh, we've got a UVA looking sunset over central Virginia this evening. Hello, I'm Storm Team 29 meteorologist Josh Fitzpatrick. Navy blue and orange on the horizon there as we look outside into Earliesville at the Charlottesville Albemarle Airport. Currently, it's in the upper 40s. And look at that very dry air. Dew point down to 7. Relative humidity down to 19%. Yeah, so as you walk across the carpet, grab that doorknob, you may get zapped by some static electricity here this weekend. And your first forecast, that very dry air will allow for a quick drop in temperature, low 40s at 8, mid 30s by 11, and upper 20s by daybreak under clear, calm, and cold conditions. Your Sunday outlook over central Virginia, starting off with frosty low 30s, although not a lot of thick frost because of the very dry air. Low 40s at 11, and then mid to upper 40s by the end of the day. And that's a few degrees below average for this first weekend of March. Your 6 o'clock readings are in the 40s, 48 right now across most of Albemarle County, although some of the sheltered areas already in the upper 30s. Look at the valley approaching the upper 30s now with that quick drop in temperature. Dry skies will continue on Storm Team 29's live Doppler radar network. As you can imagine, with hardly a cloud in the sky, nothing to show. And that will be the picture for several more days and nights. We are still in a northwesterly cool airflow. That's going to keep temperatures on the cooler side through about tomorrow night. And then the weather pattern will begin to change. Look at all this dry air all the way west to the Rockies and beyond. You know what that means? Several more days and nights of quiet weather, and eventually the weather pattern will begin to warm on up out ahead of a storm system out west. It's developing right now between Vancouver and the Pacific Northwest. As we zoom on in here, that's our next significant weather player. It's coming in the Pacific Northwest from Canada, Alaska, and it will take very long to get here. How long, you ask? Well, let's take a look at it day by day. Here we go. Tonight, tomorrow, a few high thin clouds. That's about it. Southwesterly breezes will boost our temperatures on up into the 50s and 60s on Monday and Tuesday. And then by Wednesday and Thursday, here comes a slight uptick in humidity, and then a shower chance by Friday. So it will take a long time for that system to get here. Some rain showers on Saturday morning, followed by drier and more seasonable conditions later on next weekend. For the overnight tonight, lows in the 20s by daybreak under clear skies. Some areas of frost by daybreak. Sunday's forecast, some sunshine, a light northwest breeze with highs of 45 to 50 degrees with those northwesterly breezes. Michael and Son's 7-day forecast, specifically across the region, looks like mid 40s for the valley tomorrow, Harrisonburg to Waynesboro approaching 50 over central Virginia. And then on Monday, the weather pattern begins to change. Southwesterly wind flow from Texas to the deep south will boost temperatures as we go into a Tuesday and beyond to spring-like levels. Spring-like, you ask? Well, look at the tree pollen level. It's going to increase on your Wednesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday at a scale of 0 to 10. It's a 5. Moderate levels of tree pollen for the middle and end of the week. And then Wednesday and Thursday, low 70s by day, dry skies, lows near 50. A little more humid on Thursday. But look at Friday, our next best chance for a few rain showers. Not a ton of rain, but by that time frame, we could use some rain showers as we are now entering the heart of the brush fire season. And then we'll see a few rain showers next Saturday morning, and then drier and then more seasonable, but definitely more spring-like, CJ, midweek.
It is definitely starting to feel more like spring, and spring always makes me think of baseball. Are you a baseball fan, Josh?
Yeah, you know, I played Little League a little bit.
Played Little League, yeah. You played a little bit. Well, you know, baseball, it's the perfect spring and summer game because you go to the ballpark, it's warm, you have a couple of pops, and you might doze off a little bit. And that's the case that happened to one Dodgers fan.